The complete love story of Carrie Underwood and her husband Mike Fisher. Everything you ever wanted to know about how the country singer met her hockey player hubby. Maybe you're curious about the man candy Carrie Underwood always has on her, incredibly toned, arm on red carpets. Maybe you're a hockey fan and already follow Mike Fisher. Carrie and Mike may be low-key, but the pair has been going strong since 2008, and despite recent rumors of a rocky patch in their marriage, Mike, 37, insists that the couple has never been better, according to CNN. One thing's for sure, there's a lot to swoon over in their love story. 1. They were set up by Carrie's bass player. According to Bustle, Carrie Underwood's bassist, Mark Childers, wanted to set her up with his National Hockey League star friend in 2008. But Carrie wasn't a fan of blind dates. Plus, she was skeptical, since Mike lived so far away, in Canada. So instead, Mark arranged for the two to cross paths at a meet and greet backstage at one of Carrie's concerts. Her reaction the first time she saw Mike, "Hot, hot, hot," she said in her VH1 Behind the Music special, via Bustle. And the first impression she made on him was just as good. "First time I saw her, she was more beautiful in person than on TV." Swoon. 2. Their relationship started as an LDR. The couple began a long-distance relationship shortly after that meet and greet, which meant a lot of phone calls between Nashville, Tennessee, where Carrie lived, and Canada, where Mike played hockey for the Ottawa Senators. "I mean, can I make dating more difficult?" she recalled on VH1's Behind the Music. According to Bustle, "Let's get a hockey guy who lives in another country. Awesome." 3. Their first kiss was on New Year's Eve 2008. After dating for a bit, Carrie and Mike finally shared a first kiss in New York City's Times Square during the annual New Year's Eve celebration. According to People, "We were in front of People, and he's not a big PDA guy," Carrie told Glamour. "I figured, I'll go in for it because he can't leave me hanging, right? So I made him kiss me in public." 4. They got engaged in 2009. Mike popped the question to Carrie during a quiet afternoon at home, according to Country Living, and with a gorgeous canary diamond ring, no less. "It's true," he told the Toronto Sun the next day. "We're both obviously excited and very happy." 5. The wedding took place in Georgia. After 2 years of dating, they married on July 10, 2010, at the Ritz-Carlton Reynolds Plantation in Greensboro, Georgia, reports People. 6. They finally found a home base in Nashville. The couple continued to split their time between Nashville and Ontario until 2011, when the Nashville Predators drafted Mike. People reports that the draft round had Mike anxious, and the move to Nashville came as a relief. After all, it meant being with Carrie full-time, even if sports fans in Canada weren't particularly pleased with the trade. 7. Even post-LDR, they respect each other's space. While their separate celebrity schedules mean both parties are busy doing their own thing much of the time, as Carrie told Glamour in a 2012 cover interview, "We're both independent people, so we can have somebody around 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The drawback is that we can go weeks without seeing each other." Still, she added, even with all the distance, she never had any problem trusting Mike. "Any guy I've ever dated, there would always be that doubt. He didn't answer his phone. What's he doing?" "It's late," she said. "I'm not the crazy girlfriend type, but there was a little voice in the back of my head." By contrast, in her marriage, she doesn't have those nagging thoughts. "I don't have to worry about Mike," she said. "I don't think twice. He's going out? I don't care. It doesn't bother me. I don't bat an eye." For his part, Mike told US Weekly he's happy to give Carrie her space when she's working. "She's actually real busy doing a lot of writing and stuff," he said in a 2014 interview. "I've been just kind of hanging out, just kind of being home and enjoying that. I stay out of her way. I go golfing or go fishing or something." 8. They had a baby boy in 2015. In February 2015, the couple welcomed their first child, Isaiah Michael Fisher, now 3 years old, tours with his mom, according to Country Living. 9. They built their dream home. Carrie and Mike purchased a 400-acre property just outside of Nashville in 2016, reports Country Living. They even invited Oprah to come take a tour of the land. 10. Mike retired to spend more time with his family. In 2017, after 17 years playing in the NHL, Mike announced his retirement in an open letter published in the Tennessean. "I'm looking forward to a future that includes a lot more time with my family," he wrote. "Things change when you have kids and you have a family. They've supported me without question, and now it's my turn to return the favor." 11. They recently celebrated 7 years of marriage. The couple celebrated 7 years of marriage in July and posted some sweet photos to commemorate the occasion. "Celebrating 7 years with this amazing man. How am I so blessed to share this life with you, Adam Fisher 1212. Carrie captioned a selfie of the sweet couple. "Here's to so many more years and memories together." And Mike posted a photo of Carrie, with the sweet message, "Glad I took a chance on this babe 7 years ago. Turns out she's the best wife, and mom to Izzy, I could ever dream of. Hashtag happy anniversary." 12. Mike went back to the ice, with Carrie's support. But in early 2018, Mike grew antsy in retirement and missed his sport. According to US Weekly, it was Carrie who urged him to go back onto the ice. "They are so loving and supportive of one another," a source allegedly close to the couple told the magazine. "Usually couples have some sort of issues, but they seem rock solid." 13. Carrie suffered a nasty fall, but got to spend time with family. Carrie suffered a nasty fall in November 2017, but didn't share the details of her injuries until January, when she shared a note with fans about what happened. She revealed that she not only hurt her wrist, but also severely injured her face, and ended up needing 40 to 50 stitches. She later appeared on SiriusXM's The Highway for an interview, and recapped the event. "I just fell down. I was taking the dogs out to go do their thing before bed, and I just was clumsy and I tripped. I held on to the dog leashes in my left hand and went to catch myself with my right and just missed the step. There's one lone step, and I said, if I had fallen anywhere else, I would have been absolutely fine. But it's just because there was, I went to catch myself and I missed," reports Us Weekly. But there was a silver lining to the incident. In another letter to her fans in April, she gave an update about her health, saying, "Physically, I'm doing pretty darn good these days." She also noted that as a result of her post-tumble recovery, she had the chance to spend more quality time with Mike and their son Isaiah. "I definitely feel more like myself than I have in a while. Sometimes I think things happen in order to make us slow down," Carrie wrote. 14. Carrie shares Mike's support was to thank for her seamless recovery. In the same interview on SiriusXM's The Highway, Carrie had nothing but glowing things to say about her husband. "Mike's support, he's all right. As a nurse, I mean, I'm really terrible at letting anybody help me with anything, to be honest," she said, per Us Weekly. "I'm probably not a very good patient because I'm like, I can do it. I'm not completely broken. I can do this. I'd say the hardest part was my wrist. Like, I can't use my appendage, and I'm trying to pick my kid up and make food and do mom stuff." 15. Carrie and Mike continued to cheer each other on. While a recovered Carrie was off performing at the 2018 ACM Awards, she showed her love and support for her husband Mike's career with a sweet Instagram post. She shared a photo of her son Isaiah attending his dad's hockey game, decked out in a minute Nashville Predators jersey no less. "My boys and uncle at Bud Fisher, I wonder if he'll remember seeing his daddy play. I sure hope so," Carrie captioned the post. Not to mention, Carrie isn't afraid to advocate on her husband's behalf via Twitter. Just 2 weeks earlier, she angrily tweeted at the NHL for a bad call in one of Mike's games. "Goaltender interference? Are you out of your mind? On what planet? Hashtag worst call ever," she wrote. Followed by, "biggest pile of poop emoji ever. Breads, we're straight up robbed. I am seriously livid. At NHL, fix this." To which Mike sweetly replied, "If there's one thing I've learned, it's you're always right." 16. Carrie sings the national anthem at Mike's hockey game. Carrie regularly shows her support for Mike's career, including posting a number of photos touting the Nashville Predators. "Ready to cheer on the boys tonight, especially that number 12. I hear he's all right." At Fisher 1212 at Predenl hash let's go Preds, she captioned an Instagram at one of his games. And on Sunday, April 29th, Carrie sang the national anthem to kick off Mike's hockey game. This was only her second performance after the ACMs since her horrific injury in November, reports People. To even further support her hubby, Carrie wore a Predators jersey with his name on it. Can you say hashtag couple goals?